Do your clients sometimes change what they want after they signed off on the original estimate? Well, then you need to learn how to deal with change orders. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When dealing with changes to an original estimate or contract, you should know that a change order is a common term for an event that changes amounts in the original job estimate. QuickBooks Online does not provide separate documents to record changes to an estimate. However, every event document, like an estimate or a purchase order, and every transaction is recorded in QuickBooks and has its own audit trail, which is a record of every change to that document or transaction. You can use this document, or rather you can use this audit trail to document and record every requested change to every estimate after it is created. So let's take a look at the audit trail for estimate number 3, the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum. We click Reports, then click Estimate Progress Invoicing Summary by Customer. Now, here's the Kirschbaum job and Southwoods Road, here's the estimate. Now, it says it's 85% complete, but you can click anywhere along this line and you'll come back to the original estimate, estimate number 3. Now you may well notice at the very bottom of the window on the right, there's a button that you can click. It says More. And if you click this button, one of the choices is Audit History. And when you click that, you see a summary of the date and time of every change that affected this document or transaction. If you want, you could click the Print button and print this out. And you should also very importantly note that you can use this for your own recording purposes and make whatever document your client wants with the information from the estimate's audit trail. The document you give to the client as confirmation of the change can be attached to the estimate with the original contract. Showing all, the button over here, which I skipped over, doing that shows all the details of everything that affected the estimate, including the changes. And you will have to examine these details, but again, they're only for your own documentation. For example, let's imagine Kirschbaum requested 10 additional units of mason work and 10 additional units of electrical work for the Southwoods Road job. Now, today in real life is March 19th. I must use the real date and time that I physically change anything. I can't really give you example dates in this case because the QuickBooks computers on the internet for QuickBooks Online will document the real date and time of every change. So, let's take a look. If we go back to the estimate by hitting the back arrow, here we are in the estimate and he wanted 10 additional units of electrical work, so we'll make this 40. And he wanted 10 additional units of mason work, so we'll make that 40 as well. And now we'll click Save and Close. Click Yes after the warning. And now you see there's another line here, edited by Connie the contractor, I guess that's me, on March 19th at 8:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time while I'm watching Star Trek. Now, what you could do is click Show All, and it will show a great amount of detail. Notice the first change where it says March 19th at 8:15, it's highlighted what was changed. So both the quantity and the money amount of these two items was changed on March 19th at 8:15 p.m. If you go down, you could see that yesterday something happened, except it means we made another invoice towards the estimate. If you go down a little more, closed means that you had finished the job. So I don't know why they considered that closed. It might have been something I did. You know, you'll have to play around with this, but again, this is for your own internal documentation purposes to know exactly what was changed when to the physical estimate in QuickBooks Online. The document that you give to the client as confirmation of the change can be attached to the estimate with the original contract. You just attach it like a file. So I'm going to hit the back button to go back to the original estimate. And here we are. Just scroll to the bottom of the estimate, or you can scroll to the bottom of any document really, and there's an attachments button here. When you click on it, you can browse your own computer for files that you can attach to the estimate or the transaction document. Then it will upload and it will save it and point to that estimate so that you can always see it. For example, if this was the change order scanned in as a JPEG, for example, you could double click and it would upload, and every time you open this estimate, you could click here and actually see that document. Remember, it's just an example. So you could attach more than one file to an estimate. This could be the change order. Click the icon again, and you could attach the scanned in copy of the original contract. And both the contract and every documented change order, that's a separate document that you gave the client, can be scanned in as a picture like a JPEG and then attached this way. And then when you click save and close and then click yes, those documents will always be with that estimate.